Let's be honest for a second. We are all here because we want to become better speakers, better communicators, but not just the kind of communication one-to-one, like in an interview. We would like to become better communicators, the one-to-many. I'd like you to go in a little journey with me, imaginary journey. Imagine that you are in front of an audience of 20, 50, 200, 1,000 people. All of them are there to listen to you because they like your message. They consider you a thought leader in this matter of expertise. Imagine that you are a researcher like Ivan, and that you are showing off or expressing your latest research in front of audience of 100 other researchers. Or maybe an animal activist like Asa, who is speaking to an audience of 200 people about how to be more compassionate towards animals. Or maybe like Dora, our president, who is a portfolio manager. Imagine the value to speak in front of an audience of 20 qualified investors. Do you think that this will be of any value to have this power to be able to speak to these people about this subject? Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and welcome guests. This is possible to all of us right now through the magic of podcasting. Let me tell you about podcasting and how my experience with it. 18 months ago, I started a podcast. At that moment, I had zero listeners, zero members, zero subscribers, zero people waiting for me to publish my next podcast. But I started publishing a podcast episode every week, constantly, without fail. Today, 18 months later, I have about 600 downloads every month. That means that I have an audience of 150 people waiting for me to publish my next episode. Wow. I get to speak to New York Times bestseller. Guess what they do? They send me their books even before those books are published. I get to read those books. I get to ask them questions about those books, and I get to publish those episodes, most likely on the same day that those books are released into the market. I get to speak to scientists, politicians, business leaders. Today, this morning, I spoke to a scientist in England about the science of sleep. Next week, as our Toastmaster just mentioned, I have been invited to speak in a business conference in front of an audience of, I think, anywhere from 50 to 100 people. And let me tell you, I'm quite nervous, and that's why I'm doing this speech today. And 2 weeks from now, an organizer of another event say, this event costs $400 to attend, but he says, Alain, you can come in for free if you just mention our event in your podcast. I have been able to bring people to this club, speakers, authors, artists, to share the experience with us just because I told them that I will record that conversation in our podcast. So, as for you, let me tell you, since you are here because you want to expand your reach, you want to learn how to speak the one to the many, why I suggest podcasting for you. I suggest podcasting for you for three simple reasons. Number one, because it's easy to produce. Number two, because it's not expensive. And number three, because it's a very easy way to communicate. It's a medium that can people absorb and consume practically without effort. So it is easy to produce. Practically, a podcasting is me recording my voice. If I have a guest, recording the voice of my guest, uploading this voice into the cloud, and practically publishing, not that much different from publishing a photo in Facebook. It is not expensive. My only investment is practically this, a microphone. A microphone that could be bought in Amazon anywhere from $50 to $100. I assume all of you already have a laptop or an iPad or a desktop. And that's and there is a software, Audacity, what it's free, and all you have to do is click download, and there it is, a free software. So the cost is negligible compared to the risk that you have. And it's easy to consume because as a consumer, all you have to do is put those earplugs in your ears, and you can listen to an episode while you work, while you do your dishes. I know that Daniel Davis listen to his podcast while he's driving, so it is very easy. Oh, and now that I mentioned Daniel Davis, let me tell you that already two other members of our club have embarked into the train of podcasting. Those two members are Daniel and Asfan. And I say that, and at the same time I say, girls, where are you? Where are you? I mean, this is jump into this bandwagon. Don't let these guys get ahead of you. Just jump into it as well. So I know that all of you are here because you want to learn how to be a better communicator and how to have an amazing reach. You want to change people's life. So my suggestion for you is, once you finish the pathway that you already embarked on, the next step for you to become a better speaker and better and have more reach is to start doing podcasting.
I think I have to take up your challenge and start podcasting.
Say that again?
I think I have to take up your challenge and start podcasting.
There you go. First Toastmaster Woman Podcaster.
And may I have a minute, please, for people to write comments.